Hello everyone, and welcome to another episode of GTA Vehicle Analysis. Today, we're going to be looking at the Bobcat, which is the standard issue pickup truck. On the road, the Bobcat's performance is extremely average. Average speed, average acceleration, average turning ability. It does like to roll onto its side a bit when you're turning at high speeds, but it's nothing that you can't handle. It's not something ridiculous like some of the vans in the game, which will fall over at the mere sight of a corner. However, off-roading is where the real fun can begin. It does like to roll over a bit when you're driving on the side of a steep slope, but then that's fair enough. That's just what cars do. But overall, I was pleasantly surprised by the excellence of the Bobcat's off-roading ability. I think the Bobcat is a very average vehicle that just happens to be really good at off-road. That's where it shines. Although, as you'll see when we get to my Patriot review, it is completely overshadowed by the Patriot. The Bobcat appears again in GTA Vice City, and it's good, but it's not as good as it once was. On the road, the speed and acceleration aren't actually too bad for a pickup, but there are definitely more desirable options out there if you need to get there quick. In terms of handling, the body roll has actually increased. The suspension is a lot softer, but its actual propensity to roll over has decreased, surprisingly. However, it has developed a slightly tail-happy nature, and the short wheelbase of the Bobcat, combined with the tail-happiness, means that when being pursued, it's very easy to spin out if you're rammed, which is very bad. There isn't actually very much off-roading to be done in Vice City, but the Bobcat will do all the off-roading you need. But this doesn't mean it's better than its GTA 3 version. In fact, the off-road of the Bobcat is much worse. It's just that Vice City doesn't have any off-road that's as challenging as the off-road in Liberty City. Now it's time to see how fast the Bobcat goes around the off-roading circuit. The wild dogs cry out in the night as they grow restless, longing for some solitary. And it's a 1 minute and 21 second lap. Is that good? I don't know. I've not tested any other vehicles on this course. I'll just say it's good. It's at the top of the leaderboard at the moment. Overall, I feel that the Bobcat is fine, but it's definitely a step down from its GTA 3 counterpart, which is a shame. The Bobcat is back again in GTA Liberty City Stories, and it's not as good as the GTA 3 counterpart. This might become a running theme. On the road, its top speed is very good, the best in the series, and that's about where it all ends. You know the tail happiness bit from Vice City? Well, it's even worse, even more exaggerated, and this means that the Bobcat can handle absolutely no pressure when driving, because if you're nudged or you hit a lamppost or something, you'll just spin out. It's ridiculous. I think it's a shame that the Bobcat is once again reduced to being the poor man's alternative of the Patriot, which, to be fair, it was even in GTA 3, but to a much lesser extent. You wouldn't mind taking a Bobcat in GTA 3, but I just think it's such a shame that in all subsequent games, the Bobcat's just a bit rubbish. However, is it any good at off-road? The answer is no. Whilst the test track I'm using here, the Bobcat is perfectly capable of, there is the issue that all the vehicles in the game are perfectly capable of this test track. If you come up with the Bobcat and you drive up to the hills that I use in GTA 3 for testing, those would annihilate the Bobcat. It would have absolutely no chance at all. Don't believe what I'm saying? Let's put a Sentinel, the standard saloon, up against the Bobcat on the track then and see which one is faster. The Bobcat got a 33 second time, and the Sentinel gets a time of 30 seconds. And the Sentinel did the lap in the rain and had an awful crash at the beginning. I know the Bobcat had a crash at the beginning as well, but it wasn't nearly as bad as what the Sentinel had. So that just really goes to show, doesn't it, how bad the Bobcat is in Liberty City Stories. And I don't want it to be that way, but I guess that's just how it is, and it's a shame. The Bobcat returns again in Chinatown Wars, and to my eternal disappointment, it is still a below average vehicle. The speed and acceleration are both very poor. In terms of handling, it handles just like any other vehicle in Chinatown Wars, because they all handle pretty much the same, so nothing to say there. In terms of durability, it's average. In terms of off-roading, there's not really any to be done in Chinatown Wars. Overall, I'd say there's absolutely no reason that you'd ever want to drive a Bobcat in Chinatown Wars, and that's a shame, because I do really like the Bobcat. I really do, but I've been forced, doing this review, to come to the opinion that it's really not very good.